When we're building these materials, atom by atom, we essentially need to sort of place each atom the same way you do as you're building with Lego, where you put each piece and then you put the next pieces and you form a pattern.
Kimberly Dick Thelander at Lund University is building in a new way, with atoms, to create completely new materials. It could perhaps become the batteries of the future or an environmentally friendly fuel made from only water. Exactly what she would like to build most, she doesn't actually know. And that's what makes it so much fun.
Well, it can be very fun. We can see things that have never been seen before, and we can create things that have never been done before. And that can be, in a way, a very creative process, but it's also quite fascinating just to see things happening that no one's ever seen.
The difficult, almost impossible thing is, of course, that atoms are much smaller than Lego pieces. Atoms are only a few billionths of a meter. A human hair is roughly as wide as 500,000 carbon atoms in a row. If an atom in your hand were the size of a Lego piece, then your hand would be the size of planet Earth. And now Kimberly not only wants to see the atoms, but to be able to build with them as well. This desire to work with the smallest of things came early at her home in Canada. There, she grew up in the small town of Marathon, 100 miles away from the nearest bigger city.
There's an industry, but there's not much else. So since this was an industry town, it was, of course, very uncommon for people to have university education. Actually, I was the first one in my family to go to university.
When she got into university, it was covered by the local newspaper. Kimberly remembers the point when she got hooked on the possibilities of working with the smallest objects.
So I went to the University of Notre Dame, which is in Indiana, and one of the projects they had that one of the professors was suggesting was to look at how very small gold particles melt when they become smaller than a certain size. So this is something I'd never heard of before, that when you make a material smaller, you can change its properties, and that essentially you can design the properties of a material, turn it into something new, just by making it small.
Because atoms are so small, they cannot be seen with an ordinary microscope. So Kimberly built her own so-called electron microscope. Ordinary light cannot hit individual atoms. The wavelength of the light is too long, so they miss the atom. But electrons have a shorter wavelength, which makes it possible for them to hit the atoms and make them visible. And these images can then be filmed with Kimberly's microscope in real time. But on this tiny scale, of course, you can't just move the atoms around as easily as Lego pieces. So instead of building with her fingers, Kimberly uses heat and pressure, along with various gases, to make the atoms move and create new patterns. It is this which is completely unique about her microscope, that she can both see and build.
There isn't another one just like this anywhere in the world. There are very few that are even similar at all. So that, of course, generates a lot of interest. It's very exciting for people to see atoms really building up to form something.
Now, Kimberly will expose atoms to heat and gases and then film it with her microscope.
So here we have a microchip with some nickel nanoparticles. I'm going to go load this into the sample holder and we'll put it into the microscope.
Kimberly and her team want to be able to control what makes the atoms react and stick together. They are trying to make the atoms become a completely new material that can split water.
Now, there are materials that can do this today, but the ones we have today are all very, very expensive and very scarce and hard to find. So we're trying to design a new type of material, which is based on very common elements, very common types of atoms.
Kimberly wants the material to be able to cut through water like a kind of knife. so that it could be able to split the water molecules to produce hydrogen molecules, i.e. hydrogen gas, a climate-smart fuel suitable, for example, cars or airplanes. So, the small dots you see here are individual atoms. They will be exposed to 400-degree heat with the idea that they will become that water knife. But often, the results are different from what Kimberly imagined.
But it looks nice anyway in the F50.
Very often it's not what we expected, and sometimes it's surprising in a disappointing way, but very often it's actually more interesting than we could have expected.
Unfortunately, the particular combination she tried today does not seem to be the solution.
But then we'll try again tomorrow and see if we use different conditions and maybe heat up more, maybe we can get a different phase.
So that can seem a bit strange that we would study something without actually knowing where it's going to go. But it's also very, very important that we do study these very fundamental things about how nature actually works and how things actually work on an atomic scale. The big discoveries are made when we realize something very fundamental and yet very surprising about nature. It's only then we can start thinking about, now that we know this, how could we use it?